Dear students, in the last video, in the last couple of videos, I have explained to you about concentration of the ore. So, concentration of the ore is nothing but removing unwanted or earthy materials which is present in the earth crust. So, along with that ore, we also obtain some sand or mud related such things we have to remove from that. So, those techniques which I have explained in the previous videos, those are helpful to remove those substances. Now, after this concentration process, we will get concentrated ore. So, which is free from sand, mud or any other gangue. So, in the scientific term in chemistry, we call it as gangue. Okay. Now, after this concentration, we need to further process it to obtain metal. So, the second step is nothing but extraction of crude metal from the concentrated ore. Again, we are not getting pure metal here, we are getting crude metal. So, from this concentrated ore, we have to obtain crude metal. After that, we are getting pure metals. Okay. Now, this step, so in this video, I will explain you how to get crude metal. Okay. In this extraction of crude metal, majorly, so we need to convert every ore. So, most of the ores or the metals what we have, these are, you know, converted into oxide forms. We have to convert it into oxide form, which is the first step, conversion to oxide. If it is not in the form of oxide, we need to convert it into oxide form. The second is reduction of the oxide metal, oxide to metal. So, in the ore there are metals. So, in the first step you are going to convert that metal into oxide form. Then in the second step you are going to reduce that oxide to metal. Okay. Reduction is nothing but here we have PbS or the lead sulfide. Okay. Now, we should get only lead metal. Okay. So, to convert lead sulfide into lead, it is nothing but reduction. Here if you see, oxidation state decreases, so that is reduction. Okay. Now, in the conversion to oxide, so those ores or those metals which are not in the form of oxide, that ore should be converted into oxide. In that, first one technique is to convert metals or the ores into oxide is calcination. Okay. Calcination is nothing but heating of the concentrated ore without air or with the absence of air. Now, as we know, what we obtained in the concentration process, that is nothing but Fe2O3XH2O. There may be water present in that. Okay. So, if you heat that, this volatile substance, as you know, water is a volatile. So, this will escape or these two will separate each other. Okay. We will get oxide form of this iron. This is called iron oxide. Okay. One of the oxides of iron. Now, this water is escaped. As you heat it, it will escape. Not only in the case of water, if you have CO3, that is zinc carbonate also. So, in that case also, if you heat it, it will convert into ZnO and carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide gas will escape. Okay. Now, if you have this calcium carbonate along with magnesium carbonate. So, in that case also, if you heat it, that will be converted into calcium oxide and magnesium oxide and carbon dioxide gas will be liberated. Okay. So, these are all the, you know, volatile matter. The volatile matter will escape from the ores or the ore substances. Okay. Now, if we do not have this oxides, usually we no need to convert this into oxide form. If you remove this water content, it will automatically become oxide. Okay, if you remove CO2, it will become oxide. Here also, if you remove CO2, carbon dioxide, it will become oxide because there is oxygen. But in some cases, there is no oxygen here. There is no oxygen, and this zinc sulfide should also convert, should also be converted into oxide form. So for that, we follow roasting method. The roasting is nothing but concentrated ore heated in the regular supply of air in a furnace at a temperature below melting point of the metal. So here, in this zinc sulfide, there is no oxygen. If you supply air, so if you heat this substance in the presence of air, of course oxygen is present in air, so that will react with this and it will be converted into oxide form and you will get SO2 gas. Now same thing here also, lead sulfide, there is no oxygen, so if you want to convert this into oxide, you should supply air or oxygen. So in the presence of oxygen, if you heat this, it will be converted into oxide form or the oxides of metal. Now here also copper sulfide, there is no oxygen, so if you want to convert this into oxide form, you should heat it in the presence of oxygen. Okay, so to convert any ore or the concentrated ore into oxide form, we follow two different techniques, that is, one is calcination, another one is roasting. Calcination is nothing but if the substance or the ore contains oxygen within this, so no need to supply air. In the absence of air, if you heat it, the volatile substance whichever is present in that ore, that will be removed, that will escapes. Okay, then remaining things will remaining metal and oxygen, they will form oxide form, metal oxides. Okay, in these three cases also we are getting metal oxides. We have not supplied any air or oxygen, even though we have not supplied, we get oxides. Okay, metal oxides. If the concentrated ore, if it does not contain oxygen, in that case we need to supply oxygen. So that is nothing but concentrated ore is heated in the presence of air. So both roasting and calcination, that means heating only, but the difference is that calcination is in the absence of air, roasting is in the presence of air. Okay, one more thing I want to tell you. If here sulfide ore of copper, so in this roasting we are heating this in a reverberatory furnace. This is called reverberatory furnace. Reverberatory furnace, because here sulfide ore, if it contains iron within this sulfide ore of copper along with iron, what will happen is that when you simply roasting, or when you heat it in the presence of air, both iron and copper, they will convert it into oxide form. So to avoid that, we are using this reverberatory furnace. Here what happens is that the iron which is present in this sulfide ore of copper, that will be reacted with that, or that will be mixed with silica to form slag. So the reaction I have written here. So even though if this oxide is FeO, or iron is converted into iron oxide here, now this, we don't want this iron oxide, we need only sulfide ore of copper, we need only copper oxide. Okay, now here iron also forms oxide. This iron oxide, should be removed. So to remove this iron oxide, we will react this, or we will add some amount of silica to it. So this iron oxide will combine with silica and that will form slag. This is called slag. Okay, so this slag, it can be removed easily. Okay, and copper is produced in the form of copper matte, which is which contains Cu2 and FeS. Cu2S and FeS. Okay, now we need to separate this. So for that separation, we are using this reverberatory furnace. So where the converted FeS, that is iron oxide, will react with silica and you will get slag. So this can be separated. Okay, so this is how you can extract crude metal, or the first step of extraction of crude metal from the concentrated ore. So that is conversion to oxide, first step is. The second step is reduction of the oxide to metal. Okay students, in the conversion of, or in the extraction of metal, crude metal from the concentrated ore, has two steps. In that, first one I have already explained you, that is conversion of concentrated ore into metal oxide. It may be any metal oxide. If the concentrated ore, if it is already in oxide form, that means if the metals in that ore, if they are already in oxide form, then no need of conversion. Just removal of some volatile substances is enough. Then if the some metal metals, if they are not in oxide form, like they may be in the form of sulfides, or they may be in the form of carbides, or any other form, any other combined form. So in that case, we need to convert that carbides or sulfides into oxide form. So that I have explained you in the calcination and roasting method. So now, after converting this concentrated ore into an oxide form, so the entire concentrated ore is now converted into oxide. Earlier it may be in the form of sulfide or in the form of carbide maybe, but now we are converted all those ores into, or the mineral particles into, oxide form. Now the next procedure is to reduction of the oxide to the metal. So why we are converting this into oxide is because the reduction procedure, what we are doing here, so that will become easier if you convert it into oxide form. If the metal or the ore, the concentrated ore, so if that is in sulfide form or carbide form, then the reduction is difficult. So that's why at the earlier stage itself, we are going to we will convert the minerals particles present in the concentrated ore into oxide form. Now already we have converted that, now it is time to reduction of that metal. So we have to do reduction of that metal oxide to metal. Okay, so reduction of any metal oxide involves the heating of metal oxide with the reducing agent like carbon or carbon monoxide. It may be any reducing agent. Just for example, I have given these two. So it is nothing but heating of the metal oxide. Metal oxide, where we have got metal oxide from the concentrated ore, we have converted into metal oxide by using roasting and calcination. Now we are converting this metal oxide to metal by reducing it. Okay, so the typical reaction for that reduction I have written here. Mx, M may be any metal, so Oy, so it is in the form of oxide now, metal oxide. So Y amount of carbon, because here this carbon is going to combine with oxygen. Okay, so that's why same amount of carbon is I have taken here. Now when you do this reaction, when you heat metal oxide with the reducing agent, here the reducing agent is carbon. It may not be carbon, it may be any reducing agent. So metal oxide with reducing agent will give metal and carbon dioxide, here carbon monoxide. So it may be any other byproduct. Okay. Now this step, if the metal oxide is FeO, that is iron oxide, then the reducing agent may be carbon. For example, I have written here. So this heating of this oxide, metal oxide, in the presence of carbon, so that will give iron plus CO, carbon monoxide. So this is how the reaction takes place. So you can take any example for this. If you clearly look into this reaction, the reduction of any oxide is depends on the reducing agent and heat. Okay, reducing agent and heat. Now for some metal oxides, this carbon and little amount of heat is required to convert to reduce into metal. But for some other metal oxides, the carbon may not be good reducing agent, or lower amount of heat may not be sufficient. We may need up to 5000 Kelvin of temperature, up to 5000 Kelvin of temperature. So that will be a costlier one. So we need a high amount of fuel to maintain this temperature, and carbon is a very cheaper, so widely used reducing agent. So if carbon is not suitable, we have to find any other reducing agent. So in that case, this reducing agent may become costlier. So the whole process becomes costlier. So the cost of metal will also increase at that time. So now, in order to minimize the cost of the metal, we need to minimize the reduction of this metal, reduction of this metal oxide. So to decide which is the best reducing agent and what is the optimum temperature to reduce any metal oxide, you should understand the principles of thermodynamics. Now here thermodynamics comes into picture. So which the thermodynamic principle will explain you which reducing agent is suitable for a metal to reduce, metal oxide to reduce, and at what temperature you can get maximum amount of metal or reduction reaction will be feasible, also profitable. Okay, so that thermodynamic principle we will discuss in the next video.